We'll rant and we'll roar. Two British sailors will rant. Rolling down to old Manhattan. Look ahead, look this way. Look ahead, look astern, look the weather in the lee. Low high, low low.
Ah, the Clifford child. I had wondered when our paths would cross. Following in your father's footsteps, are you? Are you oblivious to how that worked out for him? Never mind. You have damaged company property, and you will pay. Or face the consequences. I thought you would say that. The British West Indies Company is not to be trifled with.
Fetch a bucket of water, girls, there's fire down below.
You gamble away your people's lives, just like your father. You will not make the same mistake again. Is violence the only recourse you people understand?
Britain, France, and Spain have each invested in commercial trading companies to control the flow of trade in the Caribbean. Britain as the British West Indies Company, headed up by James Smallbrook. I understand that he knew your father from his days in the Navy. France as the French Company of the Americas. Now their leader, Count de Foix, has taken ill. So his wife, Countess Jeanne de Foix, oversees all their affairs. Lastly, Spain has the Royal Barcelona Trading Company. Rodrigo Guzman manages their lot. He's an ardent Catholic. That doesn't stop his appreciation of the fairer sex. Ask Mary about him when you have a chance. All these companies have the backing of their countries, and manpower to boot. Oh, and then there's the free traders. They're a loose collection of well-to-do merchants led by Marquis Louis Velmont. They don't have the backing of a crown, but they do have a vast multinational trade network across the Caribbean. Each of these factions opposes piracy, but they also don't get along with each other. So, a little diplomacy, we could use that to our advantage. Well, shit. I never thought we'd survive the wrath of a company with the backing of a country. Every action we take from here on will influence our standings with the pirates or the trading companies in the archipelago. Things are about to get a whole lot more complicated.
A poor old man came riding by, and we say so, and we know so. A poor old man came riding by. Hey.
The men found the scraps of a letter, Captain. The writing's difficult to make out. Royal fortune, abandoned, drunk fools. Fortune? Could this lead us on a treasure hunt? Let's look out for more letter fragments.
Well, heave her up and away we'll go, away, Santiana.
Let us make a trade that benefits both parties, yes? We are all friends here, after all.
Another letter scrap, Captain. This one reads, sandy shores, rock-faced islands, surround, deserted. Is this the location of the hidden fortune? We found more of that letter. Let's have a look. How many days on this island, baking in the sun, shape of a leaf? More clues about this island's appearance, perhaps.
Blow the man down.
The boys believe they found the last entry of that torn letter. Nearby island, too far to swim. Rugged hills. Reminds me of home. That's all the information we have to go on, Captain. Let's find that hidden fortune.
Thank you.
I dreamed a dream. Lowlands away.
Well, heave her up and away we'll go.
Let us make a trade that benefits both parties, yes?
Thank you.
Celtic ground, rolling down to old Maui.
Fortune! No, that was my ship. She's long gone. Great pirate, are you? Don't make me laugh. I've never even heard of you. Make a name for yourself, and I might just leave these lush surroundings and join you.
Blow him right back into Liverpool town. Give me some time to blow the man down.
Mark my words, your time on these islands is short. I may as well make use of you.
Here you are. Blow the man down, police, blow the man down. Hey, hey, blow the man down.
I, Captain.
Tommy's gone on a whaling ship.
Let us make a trade that benefits both parties.
Blow him right back into lip.
John, my boy. Using your charm and charisma to outwit the former Republic, eh? There will always be room for you here if pirating goes out of fashion. Looking to trade?
Cape Cod.
What will we do with a drunken sailor? What will we do with a drunken sailor? What will we do with a drunken sailor?
Combs their hair with codfish bones, and we're
on the way to Australia.
One of the boys has a side gig selling a cure for the great pox. My hunch is it's all bilge and the bastard selling mercury to dirty pricks.
Thank you. Look ahead, look astern, look the weather in the lee. No high, no low, and so sailing we. Down in Chimbo now. Anchors on board and the cables all soared to be rollicking randy dandy o.
Damn. It really was an ambush. I was desperate for that cure. We should have listened to Mary. We should lock up those lying bastards. Can't take much more mercury.
What will we do